Okay, so we're going to be talking about how to solve a system using the substitution method. All right, so kind of sort of just like what the name says, substitution method. That means we're going to be substituting something in. Now, what we're going to be doing here, so we're talking about a system, which means we're talking about more than one equation, and we need to solve this. Now, when it comes to systems, do remember, if you're talking about two lines, you can have three different types of situations when solving the system. First situation, you graph your two lines here, or you solve them and you see that they cross at one point. That one point is your solution. You could also have a no solution, which would look something like this. A no solution is when you have two parallel lines that will never intersect, therefore no solution for that one. Then you can also have the situation to where after simplifying, after solving, you end up having the exact same equation for both of them. The lines fall right on top of each other, so they share every single point. So that's an infinitely many solutions. So regardless what method you're using to solve a system, whether it's graphing, elimination, substitution, you're either looking for one point, no solution, or infinitely many solutions. Okay, so we're going to focus on substitution method for this one. So based off of our answer, we need to try and figure out what situation do we have. So substitution method, the whole point of substitution method is to take one equation and substitute it into the other one. Now the way that we figure out how we do that is this. You can pick either equation, the first one or the second one. You can pick the x or the y for either one of them. It does not matter. Now, the best one to pick is to pick which variable you have that maybe has a 1 as a coefficient, or maybe a negative 1. So, for example, if I look at the top equation and I look at the y here, technically this is a 1 in front of it. That one's going to be easier to go with. With this 3x, 2x, 5y, because of those numbers in front of there, because of those non-1 coefficients, it's going to make it harder to solve for those. You're going to end up more than likely with fractions, which is just going to make things a little uglier to solve. So if you ever have one of your variables that has a 1, that's the one you want to go with. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick the top equation, and I'm going to pick y. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take this equation over here. And because y is the easier one to solve for, I'm going to go ahead and solve for y and make this look like a y equals. So if I'm solving for y, I need to get rid of the 3x. So I'm going to subtract 3x on both sides. It'll cancel on the left, and we drop down negative y is equal to negative 3x plus 10. Now we almost have it solved. Again, we have this negative 1 in front here, so remember that is understood to be a negative 1, and that's negative 1 times y, so we need to get rid of it by dividing everything by negative 1. Negative 1 over negative 1 cancels, and we drop down y is equal to negative over negative is a positive 3x, positive over negative there gives us a negative 10. So now we have this equation solved for y. Now what we're going to do at this point here, if y equals 3x minus 10, what we're going to do is we're going to take the second equation that we have not touched yet, and if y equals 3x minus 10, we're going to take this 3x minus 10, and we're going to plug it in for this y right there. So if y equals 3x minus 10, that means I can take this, plug it in for y, so we're substituting this in there, and we're going to solve that equation. Now what that's going to look like, okay, so I'm going to take this equation here, all right, so 2x plus 5, and instead of y, I'm plugging in 3x minus 10, and this equals 1, okay? So this is where the substitution comes in. So we solved one equation for a variable, and then we took that and plugged it in into the other equation. Now we need to solve this equation. So using our solving equation skills, so we need to get rid of our parentheses first. So we're distributing the 5. 5 times 3x is 15x. x minus 5 times 10 is 50. Drop everything else down. Combine like terms. 2x plus 15x is 17x. Minus 50 is equal to 1. Scooch that 50 over to the other side. So let's say plus 50 on both sides. That's going to cancel, leaving us with 17x is equal to 51. And when we divide out the coefficient here, so if we divide both sides by 17, we get that x is equal to 3. Okay, so remember, when it comes to solving systems, you have one of three situations. They either cross at a point, right, no solution, or infinitely many solutions. So the fact that we got a value here for x, this means that we have a point going on. So when it comes to having a point, remember, we have an x and a y value. So far we solved and we got 3 for x. So we still need to figure out what is y. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back up to our equations over here. Pick one of them. Doesn't matter which one we pick. Okay, so I'm going to go with, I'm going to go with the top equation, 3x minus y is equal to 10. And there's no particular reason why I picked that one, just because. Normally I pick the one that either has smaller numbers or that has more positives in it. But it honestly does not matter which one you pick. Just pick one of them. And if x equals 3, that means I can plug in the 3 for x and solve for the y and figure out that missing value. So I'm going to plug in the 3 for the x, and I'm going to solve this equation now. So 3 times 3 is 9. 9 minus y is equal to this 10 here. Subtract 9 on both sides, and we have negative y is equal to a 1. And then last step there, divide out that negative. So divide both sides by negative 1, and we get that y is equal to a negative 1 there. So now I can plug that negative 1 back over here to finish out my point. So that means that this system here has a solution of 3, negative 1. That's where those two lines would intersect.